The oceans are impacting coastal communities more than ever before.
It's not even a national issue, it's a worldwide issue. So we have a confluence of events. We have, you know, the effects of climate change, certainly the effects of sea level change is associated with climate change. And then we have the, you know, the constant pressures associated with increased development in these vulnerable coastal communities.
Throughout the United States, the story is the same for coastal communities, large and small.
Here in Miami-Dade, right, we are at risk to many types of flooding, but we know hurricane season this year and every year in the future is bringing risks of coastal storm surge, and we're extremely low-lying here in Miami-Dade County.
We're a low-lying community. We have a shallow roll-up off the coast that doesn't block the wave energy as you do on the East Coast. So waves come up and they are impacting our infrastructure and our community.
We have nuisance flooding here, sunny day flooding here, we have the tidal flooding, we have stormwater flooding, you know, we have it all. And it's increasing. We just see through our last 20 or 30 years just the increasing frequency and impact and sometimes the duration of these storms. It's not going to get easy for us.
Norfolk is experiencing the second highest rate of sea level rise on the East Coast compared to New Orleans as being number one. And so we have a lot of nuisance flooding issues, but we do see a change in water levels at the extreme levels as well. So we've seen more high tide events in the last 20 years than we have in the last 70.
The impacts don't end at the coastline for these communities. For decades, people have been moving into back bay areas near low-lying marshlands, which are environmentally vital for both upland and waterborne species.
If you really think about it in a broad term, it's a competition, really, a competition for a very scarce resource. There's only so much waterfront property. People want to habitate there. Our environmental critters and creatures all depend upon it for their very survival, and yet we all collide in this same area, you know, and so it sets up this inherent conflict, whether it be for how we protect and provide protection or how we preserve the environment.
These increased impacts and the delicate balance between the competing uses is causing USACE to adapt to how it mitigates for the damages caused by these rising waters.
As we move from the open ocean coastline into the back bay shorelines, we needed to develop new tools. So our research labs developed new science, new technology to help us better estimate, better model what's going on. Our economic policies and procedures have went to and expanded to look beyond what we were traditionally doing and looking more comprehensive at the full suite of benefits that are afforded, you know, whether it be to social inequities or whether it be environmental justice, whatever it might be, we've adapted over that same period of time.
The nation's coastal back bays are also subject to the effects of compound flooding, where the confluences of rivers, tide, storm surge, and stormwater all merge, creating a greater impact.
You know, we've entered a phase now where the problems we're trying to solve are inherently more complex than the problems we were trying to solve probably decades ago. And so I think the idea here now is we need to plan for the future. We need to build a cadre of scientists, engineers, and planners that have the necessary tools to deal with these ongoing changes, rely upon the people who have had that, you know, experience acting as mentors and such. And I can't understate enough where we have to get into the university systems and the school systems, probably starting at almost the middle school level, just trying to get people more interested in the sciences themselves and with a particular emphasis on, you know, these very important critical issues that we're dealing with today.
Vietri says USACE continues to adapt to the changing environment and is actively working to hire the next generation who will increasingly use the newer skills and techniques to tackle this international issue.
Team members that we have now are more broad in their experience level. They're dealing a lot more in these coastal environments, a very dynamic environment, and they're also understanding the linkages between what the engineering side of the house is doing and what, you know, what the environmental side needs. So there's a lot of cohesion now that really did not exist probably the late 90s, I would say, early 2000s. You see a lot more diversification of what we're doing, portfolio, and as well as the people, obviously, to match the portfolio.
Cohesion, which will develop the solutions for coastal communities using a mix of natural and nature-based solutions to manage the risk against the threats of coastal storms, compounded with the effects of future sea level change. For the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, Patrick Bloodgood, Washington.